Breaking now, today's the deadline for the Trump administration to reunite parents and children separated when they crossed the border illegally. While federal officials say at least 1,000 families are back together, they're missing the deadline for hundreds of other parents. Our national correspondent Miguel Marquez is near the Texas-Mexican border right now. So what's the situation there?
Yeah, the situation is that we have heard little more than crickets today from the government and whether or not these reunifications are actually happening. Places like where I'm standing, La Posada Providencia in San Benito, which has helped immigrants sort of get on their way once they come to the U.S. for decades, have expected people to come. They've seen none. The bus stations where ICE or DHS often drops off people in this situation in Harlingen, in Brownsville, in McAllen, nothing. It is not clear how this is being done. There are indications that the government is kind of doing it behind closed doors at facilities or at places other than where a lot of these individuals and these families and kids have been for the last several months. It's not clear why. We expect to hear more in about a half hour. We know that about 600 of that 2,500 number of families, 600 of them were deemed eligible to be reunited today. We're not sure if they're going to make that, but there's another 900 families that are in sort of this gray area. Either some of them have been deported, some of them are being locked up by other agencies, or some of them the government has just lost track of, and we don't know what's going to happen with those 900 families. The government says it has reunited about a little over a thousand families over the last several weeks, but we are still waiting for that full number. We expect more from the government here shortly, and then tomorrow we expect this judge in California that has ordered all these reunifications to get together with both the ACLU and the government again and go over it all and see where we are. Wolf?
Miguel, what are some of the reasons these reunifications are not taking place fast enough to meet the court order deadline, which comes up in about 6 or 7 minutes?
Yeah, it looks like some of these will just not happen at all. In many cases of about 460 or so, the government believes that the parents have been deported already. In some cases, the kids have been deported without the parents. In other cases, the parents might, says the government, might be in the custody of other agencies, state or federal agencies. And in some cases, they say that they just aren't quite sure where they are. That is probably the most disturbing category of all. But, you know, a policy that was bad and perhaps inhumane to begin with is only proving it to the end. Wolf?
Yeah, it's pretty shocking to think that some of these kids might not never potentially be reunited with their mothers and fathers. Let's hope that doesn't happen, but that's a deep, deep concern. Miguel, thank you very much.